After my interesting visit to the salon, my adventure continued to the mall in Ontario where we went to shop for my suit. And shopping with my suit, the first one I tried on, the sleeves were too short.
Close.
I got long arms.
Yeah, it's gonna be. I'd probably say go the body instead. It doesn't look too bad when you're down, but it looks kind of ugly when you're moving around.
I wasn't really worried about it, but you know, the girls were like, you know, keep trying some on. I'm just like, okay, keep going with it. So after I picked out a new suit to try on, the pants, of course, would end up being too short.
That's all right. Pants are a little bit short, though.
Yeah. So again, we had to search for another suit, but in the end, it all worked out because I found a navy blue pinstriped, which I loved because I wanted to go with the pinstripe in the first place. And what we did was combine that with a gold and yellow shirt and a gold tie, which turned out very nicely. The guy that helped me shop, he was very, very helpful, took my measurements, and provided great customer service, you know, made it really easy for me to find something, which was great, because I'm not the greatest shopper, I just kind of go along with it, so it was nice also having a guy perspective there. Because I was outnumbered with the girls. After picking out my navy blue pinstripe suit, it did need some alterations. The pants were a little bit long, and the jacket was a little bit too big in the chest. So we took it down to the cleaners on Claremont Avenue where they did my suit alteration, and now it fits like a glove. The next stage of my career makeover was my executive luncheon, and everything that I had done prior to it was in preparation for it. So what I ended up doing for my executive luncheon was meeting with Kevin Miser, who is in the finance field, which I hope to enter after I graduate from Ashland. And we had lunch at the Accent Room in Convocation, and it was a really good experience for me. His information was insightful. The thing that was also nice about it was more laid back. It wasn't like an interview. So we actually chatted non-business related material too, but while we were still down here, he gave me advice, and which was really invaluable, and I took a lot of information away from it. One of the major things that we talked about was what future employers may ask you at an interview, and what they're looking for is leadership, and they want to know the leadership positions that you might have been in. And for me, being an athlete, you're always in a leadership position every day at practice, especially when you become an upperclassman on the team, because you want to keep the younger players motivated, and you kind of have to guide the incoming freshmen, because as an incoming freshman, they are lost. So that's an example of something maybe a future employer would be looking for, is leadership. And another thing that we talked about was how he started off with a small accounting firm, and now he's been with First Energy for 8 years. So another major aspect of today is that the best thing you can do is get that first job, because it's then going to give you experience to get the job that you really want. I want to say thank you to everybody who worked with me at the Career Development Center. They have prepared me so much for what I'm about to go through next year when searching for a job in the fall. And really, I feel more comfortable now because I know what to expect and how to go about things and how much time it takes to prepare and research different companies. And I'd also like to thank everyone out there watching the video right now for coming out and supporting me. And I'd like to apologize again that I was late. Sorry, I overslept, but it's been a good experience overall, and I recommend to the sophomores, the next year sophomores and juniors out there who are watching that to apply for this, because it was worth it. Thank you.